Welcome to the last show of this Golden Trail World Series final in Madeira. Fifth stage today. Incredible stage once again. The longest of the week, and we've got so much to talk about.
Oh, booyah. We are going to take you through exactly what was happening overall in the series coming into today, and you're going to see the battles, the epic racing, and the changes that have unfolded earlier. Well, should we start with where we were? At this morning.
Exactly. Where we were in terms of overall rankings, because at the end of the day, this is to crown the 2022 Golden Trail World Series champion in ranking. So they were fighting for points all week, but that is last chance to keep their position, lose position, or gain position.
And this is the big difference. People today know exactly what place they need to finish to maintain their place or to move up. But let's have a look at where we stood so you're not bamboozled by everything. Here we've got the ladies, and can we get the results of, so the points of what's on offer today? Because it's really useful to understand how many points they can win. So look, we've got 100 for first place, 88 for second, 72 for third. And the important thing to note is the differences in jumps between those. So if you come first and someone comes second, you've gained 12 points. So look at this. As you go down it, the lower back you are, the less the points difference. So if we look at people like Sara Alonso and Sophia Lockley, the points difference there is 14 points. So realistically, 14 points, Sara needs to win, or she needs to make sure she's at least three places ahead of Sophia. Unlikely to happen. But if you look at the other races, the other runners, the people who can really make changes in the ladies are potentially Caitlin and Bailey, because their points difference is so close.
So few, yeah.
Well, should we look at the men's as well? Because there's more opportunity here for changes. The main one being El Hussein and Thibaut.
Look at this, 632 points for El Hussein, 646 points for Thibaut. Therefore, more than two spots, game over.
Well, absolutely. So if El Hussein wins, Thibaut needs to come third. If El Hussein comes second, Thibaut needs to come fourth. If Ellison comes third, Thibaut's pretty much going to be in there. So that's one of the battles to watch.
But there's more. Look at that. Between Robert Penboy and Manuel Merias, like 564 points and 572 points.
Yeah.
It's not even 10 points difference. One place.
And Eli's just ahead of them as well. So Manuel's not only looking back, he's looking forward. And so the great thing about this race today is that people have to try and commit, knowing that if it goes wrong, they might lose their place in the overall series.
You're going to have to risk it for the biscuit.
Oh, and I love biscuits. Let's get at it. So we've got 10 minutes of coverage coming up. We've gone undercover with the athletes to ask them what actually happened so we can give you the insider goss. But you were at the start. Tell us about what was the energy like?
I mean, to me, there was something a little bit different. I don't know if it was because they were just tired. It felt like the calm before the storm. It was more down. But then as soon as it started off...
That's not that quick a start.
It was. Trust me.
Oh, okay.
It was before, and then eventually they came, and then you could see the pressure, everything, the tiredness of the week, and they knew, as you said, they needed to score points.
And the big thing at the start was, one of the question marks was whether Bart would be able to run. He's hurt his knee, and if he's performing, Petra Mamo really can't get in the top 10. Sophia Lockley was saying at the start that she of the series that she wasn't going to do three and maybe not even four races, but she ran today, which pretty much meant Sara was going to struggle to get higher than third. But in addition, you may be wondering.
And look at this. This is Ally McLaughlin right behind Manuel Merias. She pushed so hard on that uphill segment, and she didn't even chase the segment. She was just gunning for it. She wanted that stage because that's her birthday.
Yeah, and you'll see it's her birthday, and she's dressed up today. And that is why she may look a little bit weird in the footage. But Ninka actually said in the interview that even though she felt she wanted to go for it, she just couldn't keep up with Ali today. Ninka was actually going for the win, but on that first hill, Ali just tore out of the gun. Now, in the men's, what happened at the start?
So essentially, Rémi Bonnet was in it for the fun, because we said it, he had already won the Golden Trail World Series. It was done, it was in the bag. But he knew that if he failed to start and compete in the uphill segment, he would eventually lose the overall. So he decided, I'm gonna run just for the uphill segment. So off the gun, he just went up and then he went extremely hard in the uphill segment, which was in the early stages of the race. But then he was like, there's no one around me. So he took his time, recovered, and then kept going. And then on the out and back, which is the highest point of the race, then he could see his competition. And he realized they're too far back.
And he also knew that if he won today, it was going to improve the chances of Thibaut coming second overall. And at breakfast, I spoke to them about it. And the words from Remy's mouth were, he's fighting two people today. He clearly was out for his mate. And that really showed, because Elofsine took off super fast and Thibaut clearly let him go. But you'll see as we progress up this this climb, the roles reversed from yesterday. Elofsine was sat behind Thibaut in all the climbing until he got to the bottom, behind Roy. But today, Thibaut was trying to be the limpet and trying to ensure he could control the race a little bit more. Now,
and here as well, Sophia Laugli, she wasn't supposed to race yesterday. I mean, she did race yesterday. She wasn't supposed to race today, but she knew that she was second in the overall rankings. Again, as we saw earlier. So she had to defend that place. And she was like, I am on the line. You know, my body, is it possible that I can take it? It is a lot. It's more than I've ever done it. She's a cross-country skier. She's not used to that much impact. But she was like, I have no choice. I got to go for it. Take risks.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can see Petra Mamo, he becomes vital in this story.
Yes,
he's fighting hard and he knows he can get in the top 10 with a decent performance. And you see he was with Thibaut at this stage of the race, which meant Elofsine was ahead, but Thibaut was still in control because as Elofsine was second, Thibaut was currently in fourth. And look at Remy going here. Now, it's worth us recapping a little bit of what the course is actually like, because it's 1,500 meters up, but 2,000 meters down. And that's because it's an out and back. And I mean, you know what out and backs do for your psyche. How would this affect how they race?
Well, essentially they will see each other in the biggest, as soon as they turn around. Mm-hmm. And they will know actually, once after they've gone up, exactly what comes down. And as a matter of fact, in the segments that we'll see later, the uphill segment was the downhill segment in reverse. Mm-hmm. So actually it was the exact same course. And here, Ally McLaughlin dressed up as Harley from Bird and Spray. She just brings so much to this series, and today she was really out for it.
And we saw footage earlier of Roy fairly far back, and we know from what he said yesterday that the two races this season, he started slowly, Mont Blanc and Stage 4, he's had sensational second halves and come third. So this is something to note. Just in front of him was Eli Hemming as well, and he was in a battle with Robert and with Manuel. Ahead of him, Robert was trying to lead out to ensure he could overtake Hemming, Eli, but Eli was always having to worry that Manu was behind him as one of the fastest finishers in the world. So he was having to push,
and
looking
they
forward
are.
And back. And is this the, I'm trying to think if this is the turnaround, or I think
they've already turned around. They're coming back now.
So the top looked like an area of Game of Thrones, and you're going to see in a sec just how clustered the race got, because not only do you have runners going up and down
on a very narrow track,
but there are tourists there as well, and there are camera runners. So put that together and you've got potentially five different groups of people all coming together on a very, very tight path. Look at Ali here.
Ali, and let's remind the audience that Ali loves stairs.
Yeah.
Like, she really took advantage of it and absolutely enjoyed that part. And in the turning point, she could gauge how far her competition is, because let's be honest, when Nimke is the one chasing you, it is nerve-wracking. So at least she could get catch a glimpse of her, and she was like, okay, I still have enough.
And everyone said when they were coming back, they were trying to look as relaxed and comfortable as possible when they passed their opposition. Look at that pass. We also saw earlier Caitlin and Julie Roux. And here's Bailey, bang on time. Bailey needed to beat Caitlin to overtake her. And at this stage of the race, Caitlin is looking pretty smooth in third. She's been growing stronger through the week. And Caitlin sadly has got quite a painful back and so has been unable to push. But Julie Roux, known for overtaking on the up on stage four, here she is already.
And look at the bib, best sprinter.
Yeah, crazy. What is going on? So look at this turnaround. You see three runners together. We've just seen Elise come. And then there's also the open category. And trying to get through, I guess she was trying to film this. And it was so hard to pick a route that you're going to crash into people even if you try and do the right thing. But you can see what we were talking about before. You had Elusine now leading the charge because he needed to shake off Thibaut. He's never been in this position before. In fact, it's Petro leading the charge. And Thibaut is behind just trying to control things.
And there he is. After a conservative start, look at Rui Ueda.
Wow.
He's now pedal to the metal. He had still gas in the tank and now he's making his move.
Wow. Did you see how fast he overtook four people? So he was in about eighth position at this stage. Just over halfway but in terms of the downhill, still about 2,000 meters to take down. But look at Julie Roux. We know her as an overall runner. She did well on the up, but she's starting to really push more than any of the other athletes ahead of her, which was really surprising because I didn't know she was that good at the down, but it shows you at Golden Trail you've got to be.
She's very strong over the long distance. Like, she can just handle the pounding and everything. And so what happened with her is that the sprint segment was just before the downhill segment.
Okay.
And she was going for it because she had the best sprinter, bib.
Yeah.
And what happened is that by going pedal to the metal, being full gas on that sprint segment, she ended up passing Bailey. And she was like, oh crap, I'm 9-3rd.
Wow.
Or she was actually in fourth at that point because Sophia Lockley, there we go. Sophia Lockley was still ahead.
Yeah.
But she was going to push on the downhill. And by the finish, we'll see another change in the
and
ranking.
But look at this. This is
team of the day.
Yeah, absolutely. So they pushed hard. What we didn't expect is that Petro and Elhussein would start working together because Petro wanted the points as much as Elhussein did. And Elhussein actually said to him around the 20K mark, if you're going to go, go now because I need your help and you need to push away. And together they worked down it, knowing that Petro's got the speed, Elhussein's slightly better technically, and they started to push away from Thibaut. Now remember, if Elhussein finishes second and Thibaut's in fourth, it's fine. So actually, at this stage in the race, Thibaut is still looking good, but remember who is coming from before. Roy is absolutely firing down. So we can
look at them flying down that hill.
So he's still hanging on, but look, Roy is coming. And important for Danny as well. At this stage of the race, he's thinking he's got no chance of improving, but Manu has not been pressing in the way we thought. And Danny doesn't know it yet, but if he keeps on running, he's still got a chance to overtake. So we're coming up to the closing sections now. Did you see what Thibaut did there?
Looking back.
This is also another time when, at the bottom, Roy is closing in fast. We haven't quite got that footage, but Roy ends up in second place by the bottom of the hill with only a few kilometers left. Who are you backing at that point?
I don't know, but at this point, I was just looking at these images, like this slow-mo, absolutely beautiful and in order.
Yeah.
And so what we just saw is that Julie Roux has moved in third.
Wow.
Actually, Bailey had now moved in fourth.
And Bailey is an incredible descender as well. Like, really, really well known for it. But you can see Roy was catching up.
Ooh.
I didn't know.
Oi.
Ouch. Roy was catching up. And so again, they joined together and Petro pushed. Look at this. Second, so where is Thibaut going to finish? Roy,
who was at some point in second place, yeah, got actually passed because, again, Elusine and Petrov worked together. And look at she, for her birthday, she actually scored the stage win. She was absolutely delighted because she skipped yesterday.
Yeah.
She really wanted to be fresh for that day. And then look at Nienke, also like spent, rightfully so. She's run every single stage. Look at this, Bailey giving everything she had as well. All these women just went for it so hard.
And you think Ali's run three races and won two of them. You can see why Sophia started to get caught.
Yes, her knee was bothering her. And look at these two. I was actually talking with
They're Spanish teammates.
They were saying, like, they've been racing each other for the last 12 kilometers. Yeah. So right by the end, it's like, hey, we're not going to sprint each other. There's no way.
Yeah, just unbelievable race. And that's what you want from a stage race, constantly changing. And if you think how big some of the leads were all the way through that field, people were committed to racing. But I think we've got a bit of a surprise, don't we?
We sure did. But do we know now, you mean?
No. Well, we don't. You have a good point. We've got the segment winners first.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
I'm reading the wrong thing. Apologies.
All right, segments from the day. Men and women, let's look at it. No surprise here in the men's. Rémi Bonnet really went for it. Sam Hendry in second position. That was actually funny because he went past us and he's like, I can't believe this. Yeah. I went all out and Remy's still 40 seconds ahead of me.
And he's been tired all week. So Sam, we salute you for that performance. But looking down, look at the best downhill. Someone new, someone local. And we'll see their finish of them in a minute. Charlotte again, absolute queen of downhill.
Julie Roux, who did really go for the sprint. She actually got the fastest time. And Jordan Clay is back on top after like they've been battling it with Andre Vitek.
He was surprised. Let's have a look at the footage. I mean, I could watch Remy all day running uphill.
And that's what that was his sole purpose for racing today. Yeah. The uphill segment. And so once he got for it, just kind of relaxed a little bit. But then eventually he was like, well, you know, I'm just going to keep jogging. He recovered and he said after that. And Ali did not go for the segment. Yeah. I actually asked her. She's like, no, I just wanted to run away from everyone.
Yeah, and that at this stage, the tactic of taking a day off actually makes such a difference to how tired your legs are. And she's seriously moving.
And Nienke said as well, like at the start, she started to try and push to catch up with Ali.
So we only got that footage of him today. This is footage of him yesterday. And look, he's running with poles. So depending on the downhill, changes whether he's got an advantage or not.
And this is Charlotte.
I mean, Charlotte won by about, I think, 25 seconds today.
And she said she had to kind of navigate around people. And she said even, like, she had to hold on to someone not to make them fall. So kudos to her for not only getting the segment, but look, trying to pass. And then she was holding on to that other person, I think, just to make sure. No, there was another one.
Super hard to time. And Jordan, I didn't think Jordan would get this because Andre's so fast. And
Jordan actually also said in the press conference, it was like, I went out a bit too fast and I thought I would blow up halfway through. So just kind of held on. But eventually when he crossed the finish line, you were the one, I believe, telling him.
He ran past me and I gave him a cheer for the UK. But, look at this. This is mid-race. She goes on for third. Imagine what lactic is building in her legs right now that she has to carry down pretty much the whole hill to the end. Oh, she's not going to be dancing well tonight, that's for sure. Or maybe. Maybe that's how she recovers. I mean, how can you doubt?
All right, over segments. Now, for the week, that means all the cumulative segments for every five stage. So that means anybody who has skipped a stage, boom, out.
Yeah.
So there we go. Fastest climber, Nienke Brinkman and Rémi Bonnet. Yeah. No surprise here. Fastest downhiller, Charlotte Moerman, who really went for it. And then Andrés Krákowiak, again, who's been battling it so much with Roberto Baggio, but he just wasn't enough. And then best sprinter, Nienke Brinkman, and best sprinter in the men's, Andre Vitek.
Yeah, fair play,
Legend.
Andre.
He
gave it. I mean, when you fall and bounce back up just to keep in it, this is why to win this title. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Now, is this a stage we have the secret guest? We've had a long day. We're going to have a look for the shake of the heads or not from the studio. Are we... Not yet. We're... So next up, we are heading to the top five, the top 10 of today.
It's been a long week. Let's be honest. We're squeezing a lot of things in a few hours, but let's put it this way. Top 10 of today's stage five. Adam Claflin, as we said, took the win ahead of Ninka Brinkman. Julia, who came back really, really strong after the string segment. Belly Kowalczyk held on, and Sofia Lokli moved back a little bit because of a really sore knee. Luckily, talked to her at the finish, and hopefully she'll be all right. It's no big damage. Sarah Alonso and Malin Olsa finished together.
And a quick shout out to Malin, who finishes overall of the national series. Great performance.
Oh, yeah. We're gonna be seeing a lot of that young lady in the next year's Golden Trail World Series. But more on this later. Elise Bosset and Johanna Alström, thanks to her very strong result yesterday, is now in the top. Today's top 10.
And I think we're going to the men's next. I believe, yes, we are. Fantastic. Look at that. So close by Thibaut.
Oh. And Rui, who's been undercover for the first part of the race, has just popped up. And again, at the bottom of the downhill, was second. And then eventually the team, Elusine and Petro, passed him back for Rui to finish fourth. But
and look at that. Sixth, Robert. Tenth, Eli. Is it enough for Robert to overtake him? And shout out to Manuel. I believe he was overall the national winner. He's been fantastic all week. Incredible. It's certainly between him and Thomas. And they are teammates for Austria and Germany.
Yeah, indeed. All right. Now let's look at the overall.
Oh, I mean, this is where they started today. This is today's results. What do we think is going to happen here? I mean, we can see Sofia finished ahead of Sara. And great performance. But who really impressed you in today and the change that happened? I mean, Ali jumps into the top 10.
Yeah, she did indeed. For me, Julie Roux, even though she's still in seven, she probably saved her position there.
And Therese Leboeuf, actually, we've not spoken much about her this week, but she has been fighting every day and she's been absolutely so tired since yesterday. She's been hanging on in there for that 10th. Fair play.
So essentially the big move today was Bailey and Caitlin after today's stage that switched one position.
Yeah, and Caitlin's been really, really in huge pain all week. So I don't think it was a surprise to her. It's just a shame that she couldn't fight at her best today. But let's look at the men's and see what changes have happened. Wow.
Overall men on your left once again before today's stage and then overall after today's stage, essentially the overall men's ranking.
Yeah, and look at that. El Hussein has come through by 6 points, I believe, to take second. I just didn't think that would happen today. I really didn't. And Eli hangs on, but Danny leapfrogs Manuel, who I just think his heart wasn't in it after, you know, he's had a really tough week.
It's hard to tell, especially like at the very beginning of the week, he was saying that, you know, the longer the better, and he was really looking forward to that stage. He was hoping that he would do well, but like,
if your head's not in it.
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard. And again, like a lot of things can happen indeed over a whole week of racing.
And Petra Mamo jumping in at the last chance to the top 10.
Yes, because indeed Bart, who was number 10 because of a sore knee, he tried. We saw him this morning warming up, but he said, I just could not run on this sore knee. He was injured. He had stitches. Yeah, it just wasn't going to happen.
Congrats, Petra. That's some supercalifragilist racing, believe me. So now I believe we have a special guest. Who could it possibly be? No, we don't. We don't. Wrong again. So are we going for the athletes of the day instead? Well, I believe you've got a couple of people you're thinking of for athlete of the day. But
I mean, there is one. There's one 100%. And I might be biased again.
Yeah.
But she's been coming here. She's been doing the Golden Trail World Series this whole season, committing to it, and in coming to the final, fit and ready to battle. And then on first day, took a fall and so happened to fall on her back with the GPS tracker right, like crushing on her spine. And she's been spending the week in a world of pain. But you know, when a lot of people could actually be like pulling the plug and like, okay, I'm just gonna back off, or I'm just gonna like just throw the towel, essentially. Nope, she's just grinded every single day. And I mean, it was almost like sad to watch because you could see she was hurting.
Who is it? Bad.
Who is it?
Yeah.
Have you picked it up so far?
Well, I've got to be honest. She almost ripped herself a new one. And yesterday, when we were talking over dinner, she was leaning in and I thought she was doing an impression of a cowboy. And it turned out it's because she can't sit on a chair without pain. She can't lie on a bed without pain.
And yet, today, once again, she ran the whole fifth stage, still in a world of pain, but committed and got it done. Kudos to you. That's my nomination for the day, Caitlin Fielder.
I mean, I agree. Yeah, she's got to be Caitlin. Absolute champion. You saw the fight she put out there. Even though she knew Belly was ahead, she fought all the way to the line.
So for the grit,
can we rack it up, sir? Amazing. But we've thrown in Athlete of the Week. And there's someone who we had a hard think about this because we wanted to make sure we got it right.
And it's hard because, you know, there's so many deserving athletes. Essentially, all of them towing the line deserve to be recognized. However, we just had to pick whatever we believed was the most relevant. And that was a bit more your story. So I'm just going to let you kind of bring it up.
I've actually brought some stats. So Phillaris Kisang ran her first trail race in Sierra Zanao, and she came third. Now, remember, Sierra Zanao is a fast, not that technical trail race. She then came to the Golden Trail, her second ever race. She was on the lowest points of the elite on 156. Just think, Ninki came in with 600. And every day she has raced her heart out. She ended up in 11th on points, but she has the fifth fastest combined time of anyone in this series. She didn't know anyone else to speak to. Her English isn't great, so she's spent her whole week just learning trail. And to me, to fight on the last day when you know there's nothing to win other than pride and that education, I just think that's incredible.
I'll totally back you up on that.
Well, Phillaris, we salute you.
See!
Can't believe you got it in.
That's what she said.
True. Now, the question is, are we now having a special guest? Or are we moving on from the special guest to...
You know, we're trying our best. There's a lot of things going on. The award ceremony just took place right in town in Funchal.
Yeah.
And so maybe they just couldn't quite get it together. There was champagne popping everywhere. Everybody celebrating. And there was autographs. Maybe they just didn't get back. So what are the options here? Do you want to...
Well, if I'm honest, I think what's happening is they're probably out trail racing. That's how much they love it.
Trail racing or lifting the elbow? It's about time now.
Well, it was going to be Ninka and it was going to be Remy.
Our two champions of the week.
Yeah.
But more importantly, of the 2022 Golden Trail World Series. Remy Bonnet.
Can we stand up, please? Everyone stand up. Come on, at home. Stand up, people. Yeah. This is an incredible result. Why aren't you standing up at home? Stand up. Phillip's clapping.
And this is what you need to know. Just to realize the achievement, Remy's been trying to win the Golden Trail World Series for 5 years. Mm. 5 years he's been in it. He's been trying. And it just didn't happen. And then at the beginning of the season, he didn't have such great races. Yeah. So he even said to his coach, you know what? I'm going to go to the final and I'm going to play the segments and that's going to be it. But then eventually his fitness level just ramped up.
Yeah.
The incredible. U.S. stages, the Pikes Peak Ascent, Flagstaff Sky Peaks, boom, 1-1, 200 points, twice.
What a way to peak. And Ninka went to the European Marathon Championships. She came third. Yeah, she's come here, risking injury to win. Well, guys, that has been the Golden Trail World Series.
It's been intense, for sure. We've been delighted to have the opportunity to talk to you almost face-to-face. It's never been extra smooth, but we've loved it, and hopefully you did too.
Get some trainers on tomorrow. This next weekend, go for a run, and happy trails.
Before we wrap it, though, I want to acknowledge the whole team.
True.
Everybody who has been involved in making this event possible. Like, and we're talking...
We're doing a round of applause.
We're talking internally with the media team, the photographers, the videographers, or everybody who's essentially bringing you this footage, like the cam runners who are out there. We recognized Fleury on stage three. The volunteers, like, yeah, they've been out there all week, and we got the word, like, some of them took holiday to be out there and help everyone out. Yeah. The whole island of Madeira, and then obviously all the athletes. So again, big shout out to all of them, because without them, we wouldn't be talking anything about.
True, true. And thank you for joining us in this journey.
And obviously you, public, we love you. And
we will see you next year.
100%.
Hi, do you want to check the course with me?
I don't know what you've been told.
Okay, let's run.
Time is running out, no need to take a stroll.